Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, then let me tell you that I'm Shrestha and this is my YouTube channel. So for today's video, I am back with another everyday makeup look. I know I have done it in the past, but this time it is a little different because as we are transitioning to winter, I am incorporating a few more steps in my makeup routine because I am not going to sweat a lot like I used to sweat in the summers, or I do sweat in the summer or any time of the year other than this season. So I just wanted to update you what my day-to-day makeup routine is looking like right now, because I am doing it day-to-day and I am going to my university or to anywhere that I'm going. There is not a vast difference that you will see in this makeup routine with the previous one that I have done, but yeah, you will see some changes in the application process. So yeah, let's not talk too much and let's just start right away. But before starting, let me tell you that as you can see that my face is totally blank, but it is actually not. I have washed my face, I have used a toner and a moisturizer, and I actually use a sunscreen even if I'm going out in the morning. So that is what I have done today. I have done my regular skincare routine that I do, and now I'm ready to pack some makeup on. But yeah, not much, a little. So let's just start right away. And for the first step, which will never change whether I'm doing a day-to-day makeup look or I'm doing a full-on glam makeup look or my wedding makeup look or anything like that, that is using a primer. And for my primer, I actually on a daily basis use this one, the Pore Professional one from the Benefit Cosmetics. And it is a very, very, very mattifying primer, but the only difference this product has is it does not dry your face out. Like, it does mattify your face, but from within you don't feel dry. Like the other primers that I have used which are mattifying, if I try to use them on a regular basis and even on very winter or chilly days, they feel very drying. Like at some point of time, if I am inside an air conditioner or maybe there are a lot of cool breezes going on outside, my skin just, you know, tries to suck from inside. It just pulls inside and it feels very dry. But this primer, as this is a gel based one and it really feels like an aloe vera gel, although it is not an aloe vera gel, but this consistency, this product has something which does not make my face go very dry. It keeps my face matte for the rest of the day, but it do not feel like that my face has turned into a some kind of a desert or something like that. So yeah, as you can see that I have used the primer all over my face. So yeah, let's just move on to my next step. And for my next step, I'm going to turn towards the concealer directly. Yes, you heard it correct. I'm going to use a concealer directly and not a foundation first, because foundation are very heavy and I am not feeling like packing a lot of foundation on day-to-day basis right now. And secondly, concealer gives me a lot of more coverage than foundation, and I don't have to use a lot and I just use it on the places where I need. So I'll show you what I do, but before, let me show you that which concealer I'm using nowadays. That is Boing concealer from Benefit Cosmetics. So this concealer is in a cake form and it is not too heavy, but it gives a medium to full coverage. And what I do is I take a flat brush like this and I take the concealer nicely with a brush, and then I place it on the places where I want. Like, you can see a little bit of redness over here, so I will be placing a little bit over here. Like, as you can see, there's a little zit over here. I'm going to cover the zit. Although if your zit is an active pimple or an active acne, then it cannot be covered because it will be coming out from your face. But you can at least cover the redness, and I just place it wherever I need, like wherever there is some dark spots or redness. Basically, I have a lot of redness on my face. That is because of the pimples I tend to have, as I am an acne prone skin type girl. One thing I'll tell you about this concealer is you have to work very fast with this concealer. You cannot just, you know, put it and wait for a lot of time and then you try to blend it. It won't be blended because it dries down. It is a total matte concealer and it dries down very easily. So yeah, now that I have placed my concealer on wherever I want, I'll take a brush like this. I'll take a dense brush like this and I'll start blending my concealer nicely. see that you won't find any difference and it won't change my skin tone, but it will just cancel out the redness, it will just hide the redness that I have, but not too much. Even it won't give me a full coverage. If I want, I can do it, but I don't prefer a full coverage one. It feels like I am going to a party or going to attend a wedding ceremony or something like that. A little bit of zits, a little bit of marks and spots do make me feel like it is natural and it is not too heavy. So I love to look like that, where I've covered a lot of redness but still it looks natural. So now that I have blended the concealer nicely, I'm going to move towards my second concealer, and that is the Revolution Conceal and Define Concealer. And this is how it looks, and I am just going to take a little bit and place it under my eyes. I can actually use the same concealer, but I don't know why I use this one under my eyes, and I love to use this one under my eyes. So I'm going to take with the same brush, because as you can see this has a big wand and I don't want a lot of product, so I'm going to take it with the flat brush that I have used to use the first concealer. And I'm going to put a little bit, because I just want to cancel the darkness that I have under my eyes, and a little bit on the middle portion, as I want to highlight it ever so slightly. After blending, you won't be even understanding that I have done it. It won't look like I have done a lot of things. So let's just start blending. I'm not going to drag this concealer a lot towards the outer portion of my forehead. I'm just going to place it in the middle. And now let's start blending the under eyes. You can use a sponge for this, but when I do this, it just takes me 5 minutes, and I just use this brush. Like, I love this brush and I just use this brush and I don't use a sponge. But if you want, you can use a sponge. It's not that you won't get the same amount of coverage, or you won't get, it's not that you won't get this look without using a brush, and you have to use a brush. You can use sponge or even your hands. I just prefer using a brush on a daily basis, because I always run out of time and I have to do everything quickly, and using a sponge makes it a little harder, because first you have to dip it in and you have to soak it in, and then you have to get all the water out from it, and then you have to blend it. So I just grab a brush and I do it in 5 minutes, and it just do not take any time. So that is it. That is it for the base makeup that I do. But now I am going to set it like I always do. But I'm not going to bake a lot. I'm not going to set it heavily. But I'm going to take a loose powder, and for that I use Coty Aespen loose face powder on a regular basis. And this is a marvelous product. Like, I just hope that this launches in India as soon as possible, because people over here need this product. Like, it is just a life-changing product. And what I do is I take a fluffy brush like this, and I take a little bit of powder. And first I go in under my eyes, and like I bake with my beauty blender, I place the powder with the brush under my eyes, and then I just pat it on my face and just, you know, set it nicely. You can tell that I am baking, but I am baking with the brush, so it is not totally baking, but yeah, it is semi baking, if you want to call it like that. And now I'll just remove all the excess powder. Then I'll again take the concealer brush and I'll just, you know, pat one time more on my face, so that there is no powder left, and this will blend in the powder as well and take away the excess powder, so that my face doesn't look a lot powdery. So yeah, that is it for the face. And I sometimes do set it and sometimes I don't even set it, because as I told you that I am not being very oily nowadays and I'm not sweating a lot. But maximum of the times I do set, because that is a habit of mine. It has been my habit for a very long time. So I'm just going to spritz a little bit of setting spray. And this is from NYX. This is the matte finish setting spray, the OG setting spray that I always use. And as my setting spray is working right now and setting my face, the makeup on my face, I'm going to work my brows. And for that, I'm going to use Miss Claire Waterproof Eyebrow Pencil. And this has a spoolie at one end and the pencil on the other. The spoolie on one end helps in combing out the brows before applying the brow pencil or even in between. I love using spoolies on the brows because it helps me getting an even application on the brows of the brow products. I don't really show how I do my brows on my videos, but today I am showing you. But of course it will be on fast forward motion, because otherwise you have to wait for at least 10 to 15 minutes and see me doing my brows. So I will be putting it in fast forward motion. So my brows are done, and let me tell you that officially I have completed 90% of my makeup. Sometimes I just leave it like this and just add a lip color and I go out. Sometimes I just do my eyeliner and a little bit of mascara and I set off from my home. And sometimes even I blush and contour a little bit, ever so slightly. So for today's video I'm going to do that, and for that I'm going to use the Master Contour Palette from Maybelline. And I have featured this product a lot of times in my previous videos, and I don't think that I have to speak a lot about this product. You know how much I love this product. But let me tell you, I'm going to contour very, very, very lightly. Like, I don't think that you can even understand on camera, like camera will pick up. But in person, you can understand a little bit. Like, in the mirror, I can see a little bit of warmth that is being added to my cheeks, but nothing much, because I don't like to contour and use blush on the regular basis for my day-to-day makeup look. But I'm going to use very lightly, very light-handedly, and very less product. And even for my blush, I'm going to use the same palette, and I'm going to just take the blush a little bit. I'm just going to tint my apples of the cheeks. And that is it. I'm not going to do anything else with my blushing and my contouring. For highlighting, I do of course use a highlighter more than I use a blush or a contour, but sometimes I even skip the highlighter as well. But for today's video, I'm going to use the highlighter, and that is from the Makeup Revolution. It is the Pro Illuminate. You know how much I love this highlighter. And again, nothing like I do for my glam makeup look, something very subtle, but a little glowy, a little shiny, a little shimmery. Actually, very little. For my eyes, which I generally prefer, I leave it with the mascara and I just put a little bit of highlighter on my inner corners and under my brow bone. So that is what I'm going to do. sometimes I do also cover the upper eyes with concealer and a little bit of powder so that it evens out, but sometimes I leave it like this because as my eyelids are a little pigmented, they feel like I have added a darker shade. I don't know if that makes any sense, but for me it does. So I tend to leave it, but sometimes I do use, and also sometimes I use the contouring or the blush color a little bit with a fluffy brush all over my eyes, but I'm not going to do that. But I'm going to add a mascara, because if I don't do anything with my eyes, if I don't do anything with my face, but I have to go out and I don't want to do anything with my face or my eyes, there are two things that I will use, and I cannot leave my house without these two things, that is one mascara and two lip color. And no matter what kind of eye look I'm going for, what kind of a face makeup I'm using, I'm going for glam makeup or am I going for a day-to-day natural makeup, I just cannot live without mascara and my lip color. And for today's video, I am going to use False/Superstar mascara from L'Oreal Paris. You know how much I love this mascara and how much this mascara works for me. And if you don't know, then let me tell you that this mascara has two ends, one with the primer and one with the actual mascara. What the primer does is it helps in making the mascara stay on for a very long time, and also it adds a little bit of length and volume to my eyelashes. And but I'm not going to use the primer today because I don't need the primer today. I'm just okay with the mascara. Like, the actual mascara works wonderful in itself. Like, even if you don't use the primer, it is okay, you don't have to. And I know the primer adds a little bit of volume, a little bit of length, but that's fine. I don't need that much volume, that much length, and that much curl on my day-to-day life. I will be needing that on my glam days. But this mascara in itself is a marvelous mascara. Like, I'm very picky about mascaras and I do not like a lot of mascaras. Like, I stick to one or two mascaras only from each brand, or from, and I don't even like a lot of mascaras from a lot of brands. But other than Maybelline, I love L'Oreal's mascara. So yeah, that is it for my mascara and for my eyes, and my eye makeup and my face makeup is done. The only thing that is left is my lips. And for my lips, I generally go for a nudie color, for a pinky color, and even with my bare eyes I can go for some pop of color, but I personally love nude colors, so I either go for a hot latte from Color Bar or Kashi from Nykaa, the Matte to Last liquid lipstick. But I do keep changing, and there is nothing that I use every day. I always change. So today I'm going to use Kashi from Nykaa, and I'm going to use very little, and I'm going to pat it with my fingers. So yeah, with this step, my everyday glam makeup has completed, and this is what I actually do on my regular basis. I don't know, in the month of December or January, I might add two or three more steps, or I might change few things, but right now I'm loving this and I'm doing this, and I am pretty happy with this makeup, and I hope that you will also like this makeup. And as you can see, this is very easy and it does not take a lot of time. Perfect before you are stepping out of your house for your work or for your college or for your university. So yeah, I hope you liked this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, then don't forget to hit the like button and also subscribe to my channel, and also don't forget to ring the bell beside the subscribe button, because that will allow you to get a notification every time I upload a new video. Also, one more thing that I want to tell you is that you don't have to use the same exact products that I have used. You can rock and roll with anything that you love, anything that suits you. These are what I like and I love and I use. Doesn't really mean that you have to use the same products, but if you want to check them out, want to buy these products, then I'll be linking them in the description box below. You can check them out from there. Also, my description box has one more thing, that is my Instagram account details, because if you're not following my Instagram already, then I will love to host you on my Instagram makeup party, because I post a lot of makeup and skincare stuffs on Instagram throughout the week. So I hope to see you there. So yeah, that has been said. I'm going to end this video right over here. and I promise you to see you on my next video. Bye.